Well, let's talk about now treating patients, managing patients with AMD. Let's assume actually we've got some plans in place. Patients are getting picked up. Who's going to take care of these folks? Is it the retinal specialists? Is it the ophthalmologist? Where do we even start?
So in most cases, this is the retina specialist, which is an ophthalmologist with additional training as a retina specialist.
Okay.
This is where it's critical to get the entire community involved of a patient. Because as Jared pointed out, the patient often has the family or the friends involved in bringing the patient in. And it's critical that they and their entire support network understand this is a chronic disease that in my conversation with patients is not curable. We have really good treatments for this, but it requires ongoing treatment.
So you're telling me right off the bat, specialist, retina specialist, ophthalmologist should refer everybody up. And is this getting paid for?
Yeah, oh, definitely. I think when somebody has wet AMD, they get in to see a retina specialist. We're definitely getting paid to provide that care for patients. I think another equally important reason to enlist a retina specialist rather than a general ophthalmologist is that the misdiagnosis of wet AMD can have devastating impacts. First of all, if it's missed and the patient goes untreated, permanent vision loss. If somebody has a masquerade type lesion and they end up getting put on anti-VEGF therapy over a long period of time, that's unnecessary treatment. And Charlie and I have seen many patients who have been treated and misdiagnosed and injected for years, perhaps, when they could benefit from seeing a retina specialist and making an accurate diagnosis to guide treatment.
Just because I heard this for the very first time just now, mm-hmm. A masquerade. What is that?
Well, I mean, any condition that certainly mimics another in medicine, we call a masquerade. A important one for macular degeneration, especially wet macular degeneration, is vitelliform disease or pattern dystrophy. Sometimes on an OCT, that laser test we talked about earlier, can have a dramatic appearance where you have fluid underneath the retina that can mimic exudative or wet AMD. And oftentimes, you look at that and you say, I've got to treat this. And that's where having a retina specialist can do additional testing, fluorescein or OCT angiography to help really pin down the diagnosis and make sure that the patient's getting the treatment they need.
So before you ask these guys to shell out, you want to be sure you're asking them to shell out for the right stuff.
Correct, yeah.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
And we're happy to do that.
And you're happy to
and
do
so
that.
And so I think, you know, as a payer or as a patient, I'd rather have that done with a retina specialist who has the expertise to be able to make those difficult calls in some cases.
Does every ophthalmologist agree with you, or do they think, I can handle everything across the waterfront?
There are certainly general ophthalmologists that do manage retinal conditions, but in most cases in the area where I am, retina specialists are the one driving this.
That does bring up the obvious question, right? There are underserved areas. There are some parts where the population density is quite low and the ophthalmologist to patient ratio is very poor.
Absolutely.
So I think a lot of retina specialists step up in that area, and certainly in my practice that's the case. Our practice has a large geographic atrophy, geographic area of the whole state of
Iowa.
macular degeneration too long, but you know, we do go out to where the patients are in many cases.
Okay.
And even in the West where, you know, people are less dense, you'll find that the retina specialist will often get on a plane or in a car and head out to take care of patients.
What about telemedicine? Can you take a picture of the retina and make a diagnosis?
You know, that's a holy grail in a lot of cases, and people are certainly working on that. The only problem is there's not an arm on the end of that computer to administer treatment when the patient needs it.